morning, girls. I just got up and my hair's a mess and I don't have on any makeup, but I thought we would get together today and play with some things that I hadn't visited in a while. I went through my makeup stash and just pulled out some things that I thought would be fun to experiment with today. This should be fun. We'll have a good chat and play with some makeup products that have been pushed to the back of my drawer. Thanks for tuning into my channel this morning, and let's get started. Okay, so like I said, I'm starting with a clean face. I'm going to use the Garnier 5-second blur. This was pushed back in the back of my drawer. Oh dear. I'm going to press it in to the center of my face. So it's, what is today? Today's Monday. Pat's gone to an appointment or an audit or something this morning. So he's gone. Taco's in bed because it's dark outside and dreary and rainy. I don't know what time it is. It's probably not even 8 yet. All right. So that was the Garnier 5-second blur. And I wore it the other day under something. Chanel Vita Lumiere. All right. This is a Bobbi Brown concealer. Creamy concealer, pale yellow, warm beige. I don't know why I have this color because I never bought, they must have bullied me into this color and told me this color I need. Anyway, I'm going to use it as my eyeshadow primer and I'm going to use this, I think it says Sephora. This was like my favorite brush in 2017. It's from Sephora. That I don't see it at Sephora anymore. It's a multitasker concealer brush. And it's like a finger. Alright. That's pretty good for concealing eyeballs. Eyelids. I wore lashes the other day, so my eyelids itch again. And they were already starting to get a little bit itchy. And I wore glittery eyeshadow. I think glittery eyeshadow just adds insult to injury. Can you hear the rain? I'm not worried about it. God promised not to flood, kill it, to wipe the earth, get rid of mankind with a flood ever again. So it's going to stop before we drown. Alright, then I'm going to take the powder that's in it and set it. And then I'm going to work on my eyebrows. I don't usually work in that order, but I am today. Okay, so that was something that I probably have never used on my YouTube channel. And if I can, I cannot remember it. Alright, this is the Kat Von D light brown brow powder, and I'm gonna stay off the mirror away. I'm not gonna hold up my magnifying mirror, that way I can do I'm finding it easier to fill in my brows when I'm backed off. I'm gonna add a little length to the front. I'm going to make a mess. There you go. I probably could have used a lighter color. this is what I bought. This was like my last. I think I bought this at the JCPenney's Sephora. Boy. Either I'm slept on my face funny or my Botox is wearing off uneven. Look like a hoot nanny. Okay, so I was talking to Lee. She's in the comments. She's White Labrador. White Labradors. If any of you are in the market to adopt a fur baby, buy a fur baby. Her information is in the comments. Okay. Now let's see. What was the eyeshadow look I was? Okay, so I pulled out this. It's Weekend Warrior by Amanda Steele. It's a Amanda Steele ColourPop collab. That's what it looks like. Let's begin. I don't know what I'm going to do. My brushes are dirty, but I wanted to get on with this video. Wow, y'all can't even see my candles. Hold on. Well, I lit candles for y'all, but you can't see them. All right, I'm taking the lightest color in this palette and putting it on my lid. I don't know what kind of look I'm going to do. And then I'm going to take this taupey color. Playing with some stuff I hadn't used in a while. Doing the crease. Let's make this a... date night during the holidays look. Now I have a transition color laid down. There's a taupe over here in the corner. I'm going to take a... there we go. I got a pencil brush. How do you like that? And I'm working on the corners, bringing it straight across from the highest part of my eye. I may need a mirror for this. These shadows, there is, I don't know whether the fallout is user error or they truly have fallout. There's one eye. I'm just taking it straight across from the apex of my eyeball. I still have some lash glue from, I don't know what day it was. Friday? When I last wore lashes? I don't know. So what did Pat and I, we rewatched Billboards. Three Billboards. And then we watched some Get Shorty. It's actually getting better. Raymond Romano, is that, I don't know what his name is. That might have been his character. I don't know whether it's his name or his character. I'll look it up and put it right here. Anyway, he's in Get Short. It's getting better. The writing's getting better. They're developing the characters and blah, blah, blah. Okay, there's a green one in here. I'm going to put that. Let's see what the color names are. They're Throttle, Harley, Burnout, and Chopper. I've used this one before for y'all, because I remember those names. Okay, I'm going to take this green one. I'm not sure what I'm going to do on the outside corner. I haven't decided yet. So last year I worked really hard on New Year's Eve. I did 3 or 4 gigs. Maybe 3. I don't remember. Anyway, I'm not doing that this year. That was asinine. Okay. So I brought the green to the outside. Now I'm going to get this palette out. This is the Enchanted Secrets by Linda Halberg. And evidently Puffin's wife liked it, and I think Selma. I mean, I think Lord sent this to me. These are the colors in it. I think I'm going to take this iridescent green one. It's called Ethereal. They're all iridescent or shifting. I'm going to put it on the center of my eye with my finger. I'm going to keep patting it on until I get the amount of payoff I want. Okay. I have a cloth to wipe off my brushes and out from underneath my eyes. Now I'm going to check the... I wanted to call it rearview mirror. I kind of like the green brought all the way into the tear duct. There we go. I'm going to put a color in the crease. I'm going to take my Ritual. I know, that hasn't been ignored very long, has it? And I'm going to put the Ritual on my brow. I need more color up here. I hate this look so far. This experiment is going not well. All right, back to the green. Circular motions. I'm liking it now. I wasn't being committed enough. Sometimes that's what's wrong with relationships, is one of the parties isn't committed enough. I wasn't committed enough to the green. All right, now I'm gonna do my favorite eyeliner. This is Nightmoth. I'm putting it on, trying to put it on my tight line. I'm gonna go ahead and put it on my waterline too. All right, let's do some eyebrow glue. This is my Benefit 24 Hour Brow Setter. I'm going back with my fingers and pushing the hairs up. I think it needs some black liner, what say you? I do not feel like pulling out the Tarte today. I'm gonna use the Makeup Forever. It's a black, it's called Artist Liner. Intense payoff, and the color is M10. I'm going to get the top of my lashes with this. There. I'm just doing like a top liner. I'm not winging it or anything. Oh, that's good. All right, I'm going to do some underneath too. There we go. All right, let's do some foundation. The foundation I have is one that I got in a trade. She had bought this foundation at, let me go get my sponge wet. She had bought this foundation at Ulta, and I told her not to buy foundation from Ulta because the girls at Ulta can't match you, to go to a makeup counter. She disobeyed me and bought this, and it didn't match her at all. So, I'm using it. The color is shit. Oh, so then she needed a makeover for a photo shoot. It was a headshot for a job or something. So I did her makeup and she gave me this bottle of makeup. The color is Seashell and it's the Born This Way. I don't know. They have multiple formulas. I don't know. I don't have my glasses on. Anyway, I'm putting this on over the Garnier 5-second blur. While the camera was cooling off, I put on some Ardell Foaming Wispies. And I used my new Tarte eyelash glue for that. I also tried to use the Benefit Erase Paste underneath my eyes. I hate it. It's sticky. I don't know why I bought it, and I've never liked it. All right. Don't know why I'm saving it. This is the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish in number 2. I'm going to set my face with this. Let's do some contour. I'm going to contour with the Be A Light. I'm going to take the darkest color. This is going to be my contour bronzer. And this is a Real Techniques blush brush. I always use it for bronzer. I'm putting this on generously. I find that when I wear a green shadow, I need to really warm up my face. Wow, like I said before, it looks like my Botox has worn off unevenly. All right, across the nose. Looks like I've been out in the sun. Underneath, on the sides a little bit. Put some of the lightest powder on the end of my nose. All right, I can't work without a highlight underneath my eyes, so let's do that. This is the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind. It's always dependable. I always find that I'm well pleased with the results. Also, while my camera was cooling off, I took the Sketch Blush by MAC and buffed it on the bottom lash line. And I always like the La Mer underneath my eyes. These are not things that have been pushed to the back of my drawer. This is just something that always works for me. And when I try other things, I don't like it as much as this. So there you have it. I'm trying to use up some products. This is an Amika Touchable Hairspray. Okay, it's empty. It's only got air left in it. Okay, bye-bye. That's one less thing to shuffle through, right? Ugh. Okay. Now, let's do a blush. Oh! I thought I brought this Charlotte Tilbury blush up here. There it is. I found it. We're going to use the Charlotte Tilbury Swish and Pop and the color Love is the Drug. Okey-doke. Let's do that. Oh, I'm going to use my Hobby Lobby mop brush. It's the Master's Touch number 4 something. Swish and Pop Blusher, Love is the Drug. Pop Middle Shade on Apple of Cheek. What was I going to... Oh, I was going to tell you the brush. It's 425 Oval Mop from Hobby Lobby. I've used it. You can ask Ruth. I've been using this for years. Okay, so I'm popping the middle shade on the apple, like a so. Then I'm going to take the swishy part and do it all over. I'm going to do it on my brow, like that. Across the top of my nose, like that. All right. highlight, I'm going to use Glitter Rock by Urban Decay. It's an eyeshadow. And I'm going to take another brush. I need a mirror so I can see what I'm doing. I've figured out something. I do not like glittery products that glitter silver. You know what I mean? All right. Now, I found a lip, I don't know whether it's a liquid lip or a lip gloss or what, in a evening bag. I bought it last Christmas, Joy to Enjoy, and it's red. First of all, let's put on Morning Coffee by MAC. There, that's what that looks like. Morning Coffee Lip Liner by MAC. And then, oh, that's sticky. Looks like I have a lip gloss sandwich. Had a lip gloss sandwich. It's cakey. As though we're overflowing the banks over here. We'll put a little more over here. All right. One more little thing. This is some makeup artist glitter. It's called Cosmetic Glitter Ingredients Acrylic Powder. Okay, y'all ready? It's pink.